face and will face that we are being unrealistic to suggest that at no stage will we, given the appropriate time and consultation, have to consider council tax increases as a way of generating revenue, given the scale of the problem that faces us. Now, I just looked at it, I didn't read this beforehand, I didn't realise it was actually going to come, but my calculation for my own council tax benefit is that it would cost me, my family, 47p a week extra to fund the 6% rise in total, the extra 2.1%. And to get 84,175 hours of home care, extra home care, for adult care and social services, and 1 million for children and young people's services. I tell you what, I pay a lot more than 47p. And with respect to Councillor Brandt and his Bedfordshire analogy, the people of Liverpool, as we've heard today, are not the people of Bedfordshire. And I think if it's put across properly and appropriately, you'll find that the heart of Liverpool people is far more generous than those in Bedfordshire, and 47p. Which is quite high in terms of some of the council tax bans that we have to cover. This isn't as onerous as you might think, and I guarantee in a couple of years you will look at this again. So I welcome opening up this debate, although I can't support the motion today because I think it's too late. I think we haven't had a chance to sell the argument, to persuade people about what we actually would buy in order to do that, and we would waste the money, but we do need to look at it in the future. My main point is about, Lord Mayor, I want to speak to the main budget, but I'm, at the moment I'm responding to the amendment. Should I sit down and wait for the amendment for the budget?
Well, I think that you can make your
continue.
Point.
Thank you. My position has always been significant in terms of the decision we took, which was the right decision to take at the right at the time, which was that we would take this attitude of, and I've mentioned it before, we would cut, non-statutory services by 50% and statutory services by 25%. Right to do, wrong now. The decisions, what we've seen today in terms of liability, if we had the right information in front of us, I would suggest to you, brothers and sisters, that we might say, well, we want to keep that liability scheme. And what we will do is we'll look at what we are currently, haven't looked at, 75%. Perhaps of every other statutory service, or 50% of the non-statutory services that we, none of you today, none of us today, have a look at. What we're considering today are the 25 and 50% cuts that we agreed, rightfully so at the time, that is not sophisticated enough for us to take forward to deal with the current scale of the cuts and the attacks that this appalling government is inflicting upon our great city. That has to change. We can't do it today. Sadly, and I will be supporting Joe's budget, predominantly on the basis that we haven't had a chance to look at this as an alternative. I implore you that you have a responsibility as individual councillors to go beyond the information that you were given by officers and the best intentions of the world. It's incumbent upon you to make sure what we're keeping and to see if you would rather that be kept than other things in adult social care. It is wrong. Some of the things that were cut in adult social care can be saved if we look at the bigger picture. But I will be supporting this budget today because I've said, I'm on record as saying that I am absolutely proud, and I remain so, to have been a very, very small and significant part of a council which has stood against the brutality of this government. And I once again applaud a mayor for the time, and Joe Anderson, and a cabinet, as I've said before, who have taken the brunt of this. You are remarkable people, and I'm proud to have been represented this city alongside you. Thank you.
Councillor Noakes.
Thank you, Lord Mayor. Aside from pointing out to Councillor Cummins that Luton has a lower council tax level than here in Liverpool, the points I wish to make have been made far more eruditely by my colleague Councillor Brandt, so I will leave it there. I told him everything he knows.
Mayor Anderson.
Say thank you to Councillor Brown for his articulate sort of case. I'm not going to do that, I'm just going to say I'm not support because it's stupid. And you know, I also say this to the chief executive and to the financial team. I really think you should have rejected this. Because this is crowd cuckoo land, isn't it? Let's be clear. But let me ask a question and then let me see if you can give me the answer. I hope our financial bonds behind are listening to you. Okay, because they talk about 84,100 hours. Is that calculated as the living wage?
It's calculated at pre contract price.
So it's not the living wage. We've got £20 million to fine as we pay for adult social care moving forward. That's why the Osborne tax, the precept, is what it is. It gives us £2.8 million for a £92 million cut. And the Greens are trying to impose a green tax on top of the Osborne tax to pay for a £92 million cut. So what we're saying then is that this would only be until the national living wage comes in. And then the national living wage comes in and it goes beyond the £1 million. That's what we're saying. Okay. That's why it shouldn't be here, really, should it? It's not in any way a responsible motion. And then, of course, Council will be absolutely right, because the Council Tax Support Scheme, which we pay, not the government, we pay, those people are claiming against the council tax increases. That's another area where we would have to pay, and it's not factored into here. So again, it should have been ruled out of what. Would you like to tell me how much it is then? Shaking your head. You want to tell me what the increase will be and where it is within your budget function?
Mayor Anderson, Councillor Jennings has indicated that she's going to be
I'm happy to give way to the mover if he's shaking his head saying he can tell me where the money is. I'm giving him away, giving him the opportunity. And then, of course, we look at that, the living wage, the council tax support scheme. And then we get to the stage where this £92 million that we've had in funding cuts, and we've got to now assess everybody to make sure that those in need of the care packages completely, because we have a responsibility to do that in terms of under the new legislation, so we protect those with critical and those with substantial care. So we come back to the stage then, or the case, and you can imagine this, can't you, that we've gone through an assessment of all those people, and they're getting the care, and rightly so, and we're committed to delivering that care. But what happens to those other people then? So what the Greens are saying is that we use 84,100 hours to give extra care to those people. So how do we decide who gets that? How do we decide who gets that care then? Who determines that? Who determines and assesses what money they're getting, what benefits they're getting, and how that works? It's not very clever or thought out. And that's why, you know, when Councillor Brand points out about the council tax regressive stance itself, and it's nothing dissimilar to the Osborne tax, it's a political gimmick. That's what you're presenting, a political gimmick, trying to score and win votes, saying we can generate £1 million. When in actual fact, when the national living wage is taken into account, it's nowhere near that. It's probably about 10 shillings and sixpence. It's absolutely ridiculous. And then, of course, as I said, the council tax support scheme on top of that, which we have to pay. It shouldn't really be presented as an alternative to a budget which simply actually addresses the factual needs of this city. It goes nowhere near that. And you know, really, I say this and I say it all the time. I couldn't have dreamt up another name for you four. Lily Gravy is there, I know that. I couldn't have dreamt up another name, a better name for you than Green.
Councillor Mitchell.
Hello, Mayor. I usually wouldn't dream of following the Mayor. Thank you, my Lord Mayor. And first of all, Councillor Cummins said it would cost him 47p a week. That's because he lives in such a very large house. Mine would be considerably less a week. For that. Do you know what, Tom, Councillor Cone, I'm taking my life in my hands here. Because some of this stuff, I can go along with. Do you know, I know, be careful, the chief whip's making notes. You know, I'd quite like to go out. and knock on people's doors and say, you know, we should, you know, raise council tax to support to pay for X, Y and Z. Because it would make me feel good. It would actually make me feel really good that we're doing something, that we're challenging the cuts. I know, and I believe it or not, I've actually mentioned this to the mayor before. But you know what? It's a vanity. It's a vanity. All it will do is make us feel good, because as has been more eloquently pointed out, it will be heavily defeated wherever it will be done, because people don't vote yes to raise taxes. They just don't. It doesn't happen in the real world. And we've got to live in the real world, because the cuts that have been imposed on our city are real and tangible. Just to touch on the Working Neighbourhood Funds, the Mayor Working Neighbourhood Fund, and again, I thank the Mayor for putting the money back in for another year. This doesn't just support light and fluffy stuff. This usually brings in, we get less than £30,000 in Sunny Croxton. We probably turn that into £90,000 more